Macmillan Audio presents You're Not Done Yet, written by B. Janet Hibbs, PhD, MFT, and Anthony Rostain, MD, MA. Narrated by Kirsten Potter. To the memory of my beautiful son, Julian Edmund Rostain, whose presence on earth brought joy and love to his family and friends. He will live forever in our hearts. A. Rostain. Part 1. The Age of Uncertainty. Introduction. A New Era for Parents. Negative capability. That is, when a man is capable of being in uncertainties. John Keats, 1817. Scott and Elaine Miller, a couple in their 50s, were frustrated when their 26-year-old refused their entreaties to get help. Early on in the COVID pandemic, Tyler lost his job and returned to his parents' home to live. Online gaming soon filled his time, while his persistent lack of motivation to look for a job gradually eroded his parents' warm welcome. Their concerns about his stalled progress led them to seek guidance. In our offices, they told us their stories, underscoring recent disagreements and mutual discouragement. The stories and names of clients and their family members have been modified, and other identifying details changed to preserve privacy and confidentiality. The Millers typify many of the uncertainties and challenges that today's parents and young adults confront, even before a global pandemic interrupted all our lives. Parents who have been intensely involved in their children's lives face a predicament following the end of K-12 schooling, on the very cusp of their adolescence young adulthood, and arguably the most decisive decade of their life, the roster of expert advice evaporates, leaving parents adrift. This guidance gap mirrors the enduring but outdated cultural storyline that adulthood starts at 18, when children are up and out of the nest, off to a job or college, and the rest of their life. Paradoxically, the longest stage of parenting unfolds during these years, the mature relationship between parent and adult child. While once a parent, always a parent, today's young adults are increasingly turning to their parents for needed support to deal with the numerous tumultuous transitions in their personal and professional lives. In our era of stunning advances and rapid disruptions, developing a tolerance for uncertainty can enrich decision-making and build needed resilience for parents and young adults alike. The years between the ages of 18 to 30 carry the weight of great hopes and exhaustive parental preparation, leading up to a young adult's claim on a fulfilling and satisfying life. This stage lays the foundation for completing education, obtaining a job and settling into a career, living independently, finding a partner, and becoming a parent, what sociologists have defined as the five markers of adulthood. Yet there is no magical age for becoming an adult. It's neither the 18th birthday nor the 21st, not college entry or graduation, not the first real job or even the once-defining 30th birthday. Parenting now extends well past these milestones. Adult maturation is a process, with false starts and detours along the way. Invalid notions about when adulthood begins only amplify parental worries. During this decade-plus of emerging independence, parents may house their young adults and also assume the roles of financiers, emotional sounding boards, and even career advisors. These days, the generational baton pass into adulthood takes longer than it used to. Whether pleasantly surprised or mildly alarmed by this unexpected extension of parenting, parents discover that they're not done yet. Like the Millers, today's parents contend with many uncertainties. Why is it so hard for kids now? And why are they taking so long to grow up? We did so much to support them. Did we do too much? Why are more young adults anxious, depressed, or discouraged? I'm not sure what we're supposed to do anymore. Let go? Be there? It can't be normal. We don't understand. And still others ask, where do we go for help? The Guidance Gap. This book addresses the dilemma that parents face and fills the guidance gap. We offer parents a game plan that provides reassurance and constructive direction when things don't go as smoothly as planned. The majority of books about 20-somethings focus almost entirely on the young adult struggles, giving parents the courtesy of a walk-on role, often cast in sadly familiar tropes: hovering, overbearing, and even harmful, from whom the young person must recover. We aim to debunk and discard these stereotypes as we emphasize the shared generational mission, completing a child's complicated developmental transition to adulthood. We extend a helping hand to both generations. You can become a partner to your young adult. Your relationship can allow for a component of friendship that is welcome to you both. That helping hand begins with a new definition of normal parental involvement, because young adulthood now is markedly different from what parents experienced during their own time. The new normal for parents. For the first time in over a century, parents and families have returned to the position of primary safety net for their young adults. The default position for half of young adults, from 18 through their early 30s, is multi-generational living in their parents' home, rather than with a spouse or partner in their own household. Yet parents often feel a bit sheepish acknowledging the extent to which they are helping. Likewise, young adults are embarrassed to admit how much financial and emotional support they need and receive from their parents, as if it were a sign of immaturity. However, the centuries-old historical record reflects the reality that parents have always helped their children gain a firm footing in adulthood. Whether it's 100 years ago or today, parents giving their young adults help is not only sometimes necessary, but also common, even though it goes against our long-held assumption regarding the normal, on-time arrival of full adulthood. This assumption contributes to the current reluctance by parents to talk openly about their level of assistance. They anticipate judgment from the shaming court of popular opinion, which is equally disparaging of the over-involved helicopter or child-centered parents as it is of their dependent kids turned young adults. Both older and younger generations need to more freely ask for input and guidance, receive healthy support, and strengthen their connections. Rather than blame or stereotype, we reveal the complicated realities behind the skewed generational portrayals. When you talk to parents, you'll hear a blend of silver linings alongside concern and frustration. We're not empty nesters, we're open nesters, letting them come and go. It was rocky through the college years until they got jobs, then we enjoyed having them at home, where they could save money. We argued about how much dope he was vaping. We worried, was it stress, depression, poor coping, or a phase he'd outgrow before it got worse? These comments are sprinkled with complicated questions. What advice should we give them for major life decisions? What does it take to get a good job? Is it still college or on-the-job skills training or online certifications? How do we help them get back on track? Are they ever going to grow up? In a similar vein, ask a group of 20-somethings about their generation, and you'll detect a high degree of closeness with their parents. When living independently, they text or call their parents frequently and are often grateful for their financial backup. Many who return home to live aren't thrilled with what can feel like a regression to childhood dependency. As we'll show, this doesn't need to be the case. Their parent-child relationship can grow up too. Though appreciative of parental support, many young adults express cynicism about their own futures and the world they've inherited from the okay boomer and the not woke Gen X generations. They are understandably defensive about stereotypes of their slow adulting and are well aware of their tags. In classrooms, they were snowflakes and excellent sheep who required trigger warnings before some discussions. In the workplace, they became the norm-defying, goblin-mode, big-quit, and quiet-quitter generations, with decidedly different expectations than their bosses or parents. In turn, they sometimes make jarring accusations of societal and economic burdens that their parents' generations have shifted to them. Given the morphing shape of families today, our use of the term parents throughout this book refers to any adult who has raised a young person. The term includes biological and adoptive parents, relatives such as grandparents, aunts, and uncles, and other parenting figures such as stepparents, foster parents, and close family friends. Throughout this audiobook, we'll use the following approximate and overlapping birth years to delineate the four generations we'll be discussing the most. Baby Boomer, 1945 to 1965, Gen X, 1966 to 1979, Millennials, 1980 to 1995, Gen Z, 1996 to 2010. Definitions are from Sarah Brown, How Generations X, Y, and Z May Change the Academic Workplace, Chronicle of Higher Education, September 7th, 2017. Problematically, each generation holds stereotypes of what's wrong with kids today, the parents ask, and you've ruined everything. We inherited your mess, the kids assert. Because cross-blaming increases in times of large-scale social change, today's families need to do even more to improve communication. To develop mature parent-young adult relationships, parents can initiate change and relate more collaboratively by moving from correcting to responding, from talking to listening, and from offering unsolicited advice to becoming a safe sounding board. These shifts enable young adults to seek parental guidance when needed and build upon their autonomy and competency. But when a bump in the road becomes a young adult's off-road excursion, parents may be challenged as never before to know how to help. We'll explore how parents can be a guide and help their young adults manage these uncertain times and avoid the sometimes costly mistakes of early adulthood. As family systems therapists, we have advised many parents and young adults alike who are confused by the unexpected changes and who lacked the support they needed to chart a path ahead. We're here to share those stories and solutions with you. Who we are. We are well-established national experts in lifespan psychiatry and in family psychology. Dr. Rostain has devoted his career to fostering resilience in vulnerable youth and their families, and made it his mission to find solutions for youth and parents alike. He is a department chair and professor of psychiatry and pediatrics at Cooper Medical School of Rowan University, with expertise in treating youth with neurodevelopmental disorders. He's also Professor Emeritus at the University of Pennsylvania, having co-chaired the President's and Provost's Task Force on Student Psychological Health and Well-Being. Dr. Hibbs has dedicated her career to intergenerational family ethics in her roles as psychologist, family therapy supervisor, educator, and author. Together and separately, we have helped parents and young adults cope in demanding and crisis-laden times. As parents of nascent adults, we've had front row seats to observe the changes and challenges posed to both generations. Our children taught us what we didn't know about how much harder growing up had become, and how youthful anxieties and the pressures of college and its alternatives, jobs, careers, and even romantic relationships, had swerved from the expectations of the prior half century. Our deep thanks to them, from whom we learned to embrace the experience, you're not done yet. Across our religious, cultural, and familial differences, our own childhoods belonged to an era of economic stability and safety. Childhood was more freewheeling and carefree, for kids and for their parents, too. Our divergent passages to young adulthood, amid social and political upheavals, shared comforting commonalities. Unlike today, a middle-class job used to be equally attainable with or without a college degree. A college education was affordable. Few questioned the labor market value that a degree would hold or whether it would afford a good life. The way it was for us is not how it is for youth today. We will bring our personal perspectives and professional experiences to bear as we return to the Millers. We'll revisit this family at various places throughout part one of the book.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.